Good afternoon, all of you. This is in continuation with the previous class, which I discussed in the morning. We are discussing about recombinant protein expression systems. We started discussing with prokaryotic expression system, which means bacteria, by taking the example of E. coli. Later, we discussed about the simplest eukaryotic expression system, that is yeast, Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Then the remaining expression systems specifically meant for eukaryotic proteins are insect cell. Hello? Yeah, the remaining eukaryotic expression systems meant for the expression of eukaryotic proteins are insect cell expression system and mammalian cell expression system. Because for all the proteins, we cannot go with the simplest E. coli as expression system, as I mentioned. Specifically, these eukaryotic proteins, after the synthesis, they undergo post-translational modification, for which the E. coli expression system does not support. So let's discuss what are these insect cell expression system properties, the example, how do we do the expression of proteins using these insect cell lines as expression system. As I mentioned in the morning, there are two examples of insect cell lines, SF9, SF21. These two cell lines are derived from the organisms Podoptera fugipeda. These are usually used for the expression of recombinant protein. And the vector which is used for this insect cell expression system is baculovirus vectors. These are the lytic viruses with double-stranded DNA. These are the steps followed when you use insect cell lines as expression system. First, you have to transform the E. coli cells with the gene of interest. Then we need to select the transformed cells, that means the positive clones. After selection, you can go for isolation of this expression vector. Once this expression vector is isolated, before going for the transfection of these insect cell lines, you also have to co-transfect it with another classmate with the viral genes. So the insect cell lines what we use are either SF9 or SF21. After co-transfection of these insect cell lines, you can look for the production of high titer recombinant virus stock. Once this high titer recombinant virus stock is produced, you can infect this high titer recombinant virus stock to the insect cell lines, and then you can go for isolation of protein of interest. So these are the steps that we need to follow when we are trying to express recombinant protein using the insect cell lines as expression system. Whatever we discussed with the flowchart diagram is again given here. As I mentioned, first the competent E. coli cells are used to take up your DNA sequence of interest. Then that sequence of interest may get integrated with the bacterial genome, or it may get circularized and exist as plasmid in the cell. Then you need to go for the selection of transformed E. coli using a selection marker. Then once you select them, you have to expand this selected E. coli using the appropriate cell culture medium. Then you can go for isolation of recombinant plasmid. Then you also have to prepare second plasmid containing the viral genes, and this is required for the multiplication and formation of virus particles. Then the insect cell lines are co-infected with the expression plasmid and the second plasmid into this insect cell lines. Then the recombinant viral stock is purified. Then you can go for the amplification of the virus, and some plaque assays can be carried out to increase the titer of the recombinant viral stock. Then these recombinant viral stocks are used for infection of the insect cell lines, so that the amount of protein produced will be more. Then once the protein is produced, you can isolate the protein and then go for purification of the protein, whether it is intracellular or secreted protein. Next, coming to the mammalian cell expression system. The main difficulty of using these mammalian cells as protein expression system is the efficiency is very less and the level of protein expressed is also low. These are the challenges of mammalian cell expression system. But why one has to go for this mammalian cell expression system? As I mentioned earlier, many of the post-translational modifications to be carried out, mammalian cell expression system would be the best choice of expression system. So we have the cell lines like HEK293 and CHO. They are developed as efficient, transient and stable expression system. This HEK293 is the transient expression system. Transient in the sense it is meant for very short term of expression. And the CHO cell lines are meant for stable expression. This HEK293 cell lines, when we use, they are transiently transfected using the methods of liposome or calcium phosphate precipitation method or using this polyethylene glycol as transfection reagents. If you remember, these are all the methods of transfection into mammalian cell lines using liposomes or calcium phosphate precipitation method or by using polyethylene glycol as a transfection reagent. Compared to these two different types of mammalian cell lines, though the transient expression is comparatively easy and simple, scaling up is technically problematic or challenging in case of this transient expression using mammalian cell lines. These CHO cells, as I told, these are meant for stable expression. So they are used to stably express large quantities of recombinant proteins. Here, when we use this mammalian cell lines as expression system, this process involves the transfection of DHFR deficient CHO cell lines. DHFR deficient in the sense dihydrofolate reductase enzyme deficient cell lines that enables the selection by inserting your gene of interest, and that vector also should contain DHFR selection cassette. The marker should be available for the later selection step. So that is how the mammalian cell lines are used for expression of the eukaryotic proteins. The steps involved are like this. First, you will go for transformation of competent E. coli cell with your gene of interest. Then go for selection and expansion of positive growth, which means the selection of transformed cells. Then isolate the expression vector. Then transfect into the mammalian cell line. That could be the transient cell line or the stable cell line. Once the transfection is done, you can go for the selection of transfectants. As I told you, if it is transient expression, the screening and expansion of clones can be done for a weak time, or if it is stable expression, in that case, screening and expansion of clones can be done for 2-3 months. So once the selection of transfectants is done, you can go for isolation of your protein of interest and then purification of your protein. So this is how the mammalian cell lines are used for the expression of proteins, specifically the recombinant proteins. So whatever the points we discussed with mammalian cell expression, first the E. coli, competent E. coli cells are used for taking up of your sequence of interest. Then when the DNA is taken up by the cell, that may get integrated with the host genome or it may exist as a plasmid. Then you select the transformed E. coli using selection marker. Then you can store them. Later you can expand the selected E. coli in appropriate culture medium. Then you can isolate the right plasmid, which means the recombinant plasmid. Then you have to go for the transfection of this expression plasmid into the right mammalian cell line, whichever you choose as your expression system. Then you have to go for the selection of stable clones. Once you select the stable clones, you have to go for the expansion of these clones for either transient batch expression or expansion of clones for 2-3 months in case of the stable expression. So once the expansion is done, then the isolation of protein of interest and purification, it can be applied both for intracellular as well as the extracellular, or you can also call them as secreted proteins. Here, this table explains the different protein expression systems with their advantages and disadvantages. As we discussed, the prokaryotic expression system, first we discussed about E. coli. The advantages of E. coli using as expression system, it leads to rapid expression of protein, less expensive, and scaling up process is very simple. Well-characterized genetic is the main advantage of using E. coli as expression system. But the problem or the disadvantage of using E. coli as expression system is no eukaryotic post-translational modifications can be done on this E. coli. So that is a problem for the proteins to be functionally active. And some proteins are not properly folded in that case. And proteins are rarely secreted when you use E. coli as the expression system. Coming to the yeast using as expression system, the advantages are moderately rapid expression with this yeast expression system, and it works well for secreted and intracellular proteins. It is also less expensive, and most protein folding and post translational modifications are possible by using yeast as expression system. Coming to the disadvantages, some end-linked glycan structures of proteins are different when compared to the typical mammalian protein. So the post-translational modification processes are different when we use this yeast as a protein expression system. And it requires the use of yeast secretion signal peptides, and enhanced safety precautions are required when we use yeast as expression system. Then we discussed about insect cell lines where the baculovirus is used as vector. Here the advantages are moderately rapid expression. It works well for secreted membrane proteins and intracellular proteins. And when we use this insect cell lines as expression system, most protein folding and post-translational modifications are possible. Remember, when we use yeast, though it is eukaryotic expression system, many of the mammalian protein post-translational modifications are not done when we use yeast. But here, most of the protein folding and post-translational modifications are possible. But problems are the characteristic N-glycan structures of proteins are different when compared to the typical mammalian cell lines. Definitely, here also it is different from mammalian cell lines. So certain post-translational modifications are different, expensive, difficult to scale up. So these are the disadvantages when we use baculovirus or insect cell lines for expression of recombinant proteins. Coming to the mammalian cell lines, we have transient expression system and stable expression system. In case of transient expression system, they are moderately rapid expression, works well for secreted and membrane proteins. All here we said most of the protein folding, here all protein folding and most authentic post-translational modifications are possible. Coming to the disadvantages, it's expensive. The yield of intracellular protein is very low. That we discussed while discussing about the challenges of using mammalian cell lines as a protein expression system. And another disadvantage is difficult to scale up. So these are the disadvantages. Coming to the stable expression systems of mammalian cell lines, all protein folding and authentic post-translational modifications are possible. This system also works well for secreted and membrane proteins. The disadvantages of this system would be expensive. The yields of intracellular proteins are low here also, difficult to scale up, and lengthy expression time. As the stable expression system is used, the expression time of the protein is lengthy here, though it is stable. So this is the comparison of various protein expression systems used in prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Okay, this question had been asked for 15 marks also, 5 marks also in the university exams. So this is all I wanted to discuss in today's class. If you have any questions, I'll be happy to answer. Any questions from your side?